This is part two of the Chazy formula derivation. I finished part one with F sub net equals weight times slope. Of course, weight is mass times the acceleration of gravity, equals density times area times length. And those three, well, two variables and one constant equals mass times gravity times slope. So we have mass times gravity times slope equals mass times gravity times slope. In a steadily flowing channel of water in which the average velocity of the flow is constant, the F sub net balances exactly with the shear stress of the water where it interacts with the bottoms and sides of the channel. As an analogy, think about an object falling from a great height through air. Here we have a crate falling from, say, an airplane. The air is rushing by it. Its velocity is speeding up and speeding up until it reaches a terminal velocity in the air. The force, of course, is mass times the acceleration of gravity. At terminal velocity, the force of air more or less buoys it up. Its own speed causes it to interact with more air particles until the force of the air balances the force of mass times gravity. To further explain shear force, I have drawn a stream flowing out of a mountain valley. Of course, if the water in the stream had nothing restraining its flow, it would accelerate and accelerate and continue to accelerate without limit. Of course, we know that not to be the case. Let's assume that this area of the stream from here to here is constant flow. Well, what restrains its flow so that it doesn't continue to accelerate? Number one, the stream is curving to some extent. It's not straight. So that's called meandering. The meander of a stream or river or any channel tends to slow it down to some extent. In addition to that, I've magnified a section of the bottoms and wall of the stream in this area, and we see that it has what's called aspirites, jagged edges, bumps, curves that physically restrain the flow of the stream where the wall and bottoms of the stream meet the water. And these are called aspirites. I've further magnified an area of the aspirites to show the coarseness or smoothness of the material. So here we have an indication of how smooth or coarse the material is. Some rocks are smooth, other ones have a rougher feel to them, and the water is going to flow past that in a different manner. Then I have magnified the coarseness even further here, and we can magnify and magnify on down until we get to the actual geometry of the molecules of the material on the surface of the channel. The shear stress referred to in the previous slides, which acts at the boundary between the water and the channel bed, is referred to as tau, the Greek letter tau, which equals force, the shear force per unit area. I've drawn the cross section of a channel with water flowing in it in the direction indicated in the upper right-hand corner. I've shown the surface of the water, and I've left room to draw a little section of area tau. Acts parallel to this small plane that I've drawn on the side of this channel. So tau would act against the flow. It's the amount of force parallel to that unit of area against the flow. The area could be on the bottom or the side or anywhere on the surface of the channel bed. I've discussed the wetted perimeter in part one, and just for a quick review, it's the portion of the channel that is in contact with the water. So it's not the entire perimeter of the channel. It starts and ends at the surface of the water. Wetted perimeter is referred to as capital P. And again, we'll talk about the length, which is the length of the channel under consideration. Rearranging the equation, F shear equals tau times area. And applying this expression to our diagram, tau multiplied times the wetted perimeter times length will give us the same expression. In other words, wetted perimeter times length is area. In a section of channel having steady flow or constant mean velocity, the shear force, tau times wetted perimeter times length, exactly balances the F sub net, or the component of gravity pulling the water down the channel. Density times area times length times the acceleration of gravity times slope. So the left side of the equation is F sub shear, and the right side is F sub net. We can divide both sides of the equation by wetted perimeter times length. We see that length divides out on the right side, so that tau equals density times area, and we'll go ahead and divide the area by wetted perimeter, and I'll explain that in a second. times acceleration of gravity times slope. This term is a metric seen in hydraulics over and over again, and it is hydraulic radius. It is the cross-sectional area of fluid, water in most cases, divided by the wetted perimeter of the channel. So we can rewrite this rho times hydraulic radius times the acceleration of gravity times slope, which is sometimes seen in this form, gamma times hydraulic radius times slope. Gamma is simply a collection of the constants density and acceleration of gravity into one constant. So this is a good time to end part two. We'll finish up the derivation in part three. Be sure to check out the great photo in the next slide.